So look, look, if I die, if I die, are you allowed to pray janaza on me? You're like, go on. Do you know where he was born?
Yes, he was born in 1845.
1835. Are you sure?
In Gadian.
Are you sure?
1835 in Gadian.
Well, according to his son, he was 36. According to a different one, he's 37. But let's say that he was born in 1935. Yeah.
1835.
Did you know that he said that he reached puberty in 1275 Hijri?
All I know is that he was born in 1835.
Yeah, and I am telling you, Mirza Ghulam Ahmed, listen to what I'm saying carefully. Mirza Ghulam Ahmed said that he reached puberty in the year 1275 Hijri. That would be 18,059. How old that would make him? 24 years. No. Look, are you gonna discuss or you're gonna start? Because if you're not gonna discuss what I wanna prove to you, that man is an imposter and is a liar. And he is an imposter and he is a liar.
He is a truthful man. And he came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a imam.
Prove that he has come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Because if someone claims to be from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he is lying, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not...
Masha'Allah. He will destroy him.
But okay. Azam Mirza Ghulam Ahmed live.
Okay.
Wait.
Didn't he write, Abdullah wrote for him, Mirza Abdullah wrote for him a long letter which he published against Mulawi Sana'Allah Al-Amsasari, where he said that if one of us is a liar, may he have the cholera and that. What did he die with? Didn't he die with cholera?
No.
He
never claimed anything like this.
What about if I bring out the letter? If I bring out the letter, will you take it back?
But where are you getting this letter from?
From your own writings, from your own books.
From what reference?
You know, you people, wallahi al-azim, I'm not going to waste my time with you, yeah? I'm not going to waste my time with you. I'm going to show you this and that is it. Because it's a waste of time talking nonsense, yeah?
We know that Azam Mirza Ghulam Ahmed.
Wait, before we go there.
He used to always write.
Before we go there, wait.
And he used to always prove that he was always right.
What's this?
But this is just a picture.
It's a scan from your book. From your book. What book is that?
How many pages? This
Urdu. What book is that? Who reads Urdu? Look. مجموعات اشهارات حضرت مسيح موعود. Yeah. 1898, all right? And this is the Nashir Sharika Islamiya Rabwa, all right? Now, this letter here in Urdu, he did it, and it is him writing, and in here it says, Mulawi Thana'ullah Sahib and that. And in here, do you read Urdu? And in here, he says, he made supplication to Allah that the liar shall die a bad death from cholera. Yeah? And he died from cholera. So, did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer the dua and he died of cholera or not? This is your book. This is him writing. You said that a liar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has answered Mirza Ghulam Ahmed. And he subhanahu wa ta'ala has humiliated him and made him die of cholera in his own bathroom.
It is written Urdu, I cannot read Urdu. You cannot.
You see, the thing with these people, every time you bring them something, I bring it in English, oh, it's not in Urdu. You bring it in Urdu, I can't read Urdu. Astaghfirullah, if Jibreel was to come from the heavens now and tell you he's a liar, you would still, you know why? Because you people, you follow your own desires. You do not want to follow Al-Haq subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, alhamdulillah, Urdu. Barakallahu feek. He pretends that it's not a problem. You know Mirza Ghulam Ahmed?
Oh yeah, yeah.
He wrote a letter and he sent it. You know this book?
Istiharat.
Yeah. You know this is between him and Thana'ullah?
Yeah.
When he said, look at this in yellow, please. What does he say in there? May the liar.
He said, Ta'un has wagaira bollocks bibari se mare.
Which is in English, please. Ta'un. Say in English.
Ta'un, yeah.
Ta'un.
Wait. Ta'un. Cholera. Ta'un is cholera. Ta'un is cholera. What did he say, please? Yes. What did he say in English?
Die with the haze. Whether it's town or whether it is in Islam, when somebody die with the town as a Muslim, he's go to Jannah. But Haza, it's also, you know, Mirza, it's a Mirza interpretation that somebody die with the town and Haza, he's
as a
liar.
Punishment, he says in
he's
here, whoever lying between him and Thana'ullah,
yeah.
That the liar from amongst them two will die of cholera.
Yeah.
Guess what? This was at the end of 1907. He died April 1908.
And guess
what? He died of cholera. He died of cholera according
his father-in-law.
Subhanallah. Ismail. Dr. Ismail said it. His wife said it.
He was his father-in-law.
And guess what? Thana'ullah. Thana'ullah lived another 27 years. So he's the liar. This is him. This is him, and you still going no, and this is people, subhanallah. This is why one. You see,
no, Mirza. Actually, Mirza, big claim was, you know, that he's going to marry this Muhammadi Begum. If he didn't get married to Muhammadi Begum, he's a liar. He's a fake.
He died.
He never married. No. And he died.
Well, look, another one. His son, the one that he said that Allah Jalla wa Ala will give him five boys. Then he only had four. He never got the fifth. The other Muhammadi Begum that was with him in the house when she was pregnant, he said to her, you're going to have a child, it's going to be a boy, and he's going to live to be this and this. She gives birth, and the child dies.
Then he
told her, oh, by the way, you are going this time, you're going to have another child, he will be a boy, and guess what? She died.
Yeah.
So that prophecy was never fulfilled.
No.
How many prophecies do you want me to tell you?
No.
Did he say that he has menses or not?
Yeah.
He said that he has menses.
He was
did he say that he was Miriam, and from Miriam his Yalash injected his manhood in him, a'udhu billah, and he became pregnant for a period no more than 10 months. Then he gave birth to Isa, and that's how he became Isa. Is this a miracle? Is this a prophet from Allah?
Yeah, na'uzubillah.
Come on, Muhammad.
Come on.
I will say it again.
Yeah.
I will say it again. Muhammad,
yeah.
You follow that person, you know what he's going to say? On the day of judgment, you know Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, فَتَبَرَّ الَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوا مِنَ الَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوا, that the ones that have been followed will claim innocence from the people who followed them. They saw Allah, they followed us. They followed us. Even Shaitan in Surah Ibrahim. He says, ما أنتم بمصريخي وما أنا بما أنا بمصريخكم وما أنتم بمصريخي. I will not help you and you cannot help me. All he has done, he says, I called you and you follow me. So do not blame me, blame yourselves. And that's what's gonna happen to you. Wallahi Mirza Ghulam, هذا لعنة الله وعليه. May the curse of Allah be upon him.
Say, I tell you. Say that.
يا حبيبي. Say لعنة الله على القاضي. Say that.
إنسان.
You don't say ما عندك حجة عليه. حبيبي الله يرضى عليك. الله يرضى عليك. اللي مرفوع عليه القلم الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم حدثنا عنه. النائم طفل حتى يحتلم، النائم حتى يستيقظ، المجنون هذا مو مجنون. الله يرضى عليك. الله يرضى عليك. يا أخي لا شيخ محمد، اسمعني الله يرضى عليك، لا شيخ محمد ولا أنا ولا أي واحد ما يستطيع يقول أن هذا مجنون. الله يرضى عليك. خلاص وإياكم. So محمد come to Allah جل وعلا. Accept Islam. Be a Muslim. You will. I'm gone. You say Islam Ahmadiyya. You say Islam Ahmadiyya. No. When Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought Islam, did he call him Islam Hashimiyya? Because he's a Hashimi. Did he call it Islam Hashimiyya?
No.
He didn't. Did Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam call it Islam Hashimiyya? Why do you, if he is
Messiah in the Imam Mahdi, we had a time when the Messiah,
how can he be al-Mahdi? How, look, give me one prophet who changes. He said one minute he said I am this, second minute he said I am that, third time he said I am that, then he said I am that.
Azam Izzullah Muhammad always claimed to be a Muslim.
No.
Okay. No problem. I'll finish. Sam, because I'm gonna finish with him. Yeah. Listen.
Yeah.
Which madhab did Mirza Ghulam Ahmad follow?
Islam.
Which madhab did he follow?
Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad said he followed.
What madhab did he follow? You see, you don't even know.
Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Doesn't he follow Abu Hanifa?
He follows Prophet Muhammad.
Doesn't he follow Abu Hanifa?
Yeah.
If I bring you a book where he says, follow the Imam Abu Hanifa, for the Hanafi madhab is the one followed by the majority of the Muslims, and since it is followed by the majority of the Muslims, it should be the correct one. And you see, he said to Nuruddin al-Hakim. Wait.
Follow anything except a,
what do you mean you don't follow anything?
Well, why? Coming from your teaching is coming from this teaching from ICT.
Look, Muhammad. Muhammad, go and learn. Muhammad.
It's not coming.
Wait, look, Muhammad. Talking to you. Doesn't do justice because first of all you do not know anything, and I don't want you to Muhammad, listen to me. Muhammad, listen to me. I do not want you to look stupid on camera.
He is stupid.
So at the end of the day, Muhammad, look, Wallahi al-Azim, I want the good for you. I want the good for you. I want the good for the normal Qadianis, not for the missionaries, because the missionaries are liars.
Yeah.
And they will be responsible for all the people that they misled, because they know the truth and they keep playing, dancing around it. Like the Arazi, he wants to be the next Khalif. The others, they're just looking for money and that. But listen to me, there is no A'udhu Billah in here. A'udhu Billah from what you say. A'udhu Billah that you say that such a person, that subhanallah, is a nobody.
Ahmadiyya is spreading the true Islam.
How is it true Islam?
Because we follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and we follow the Quran.
The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ana khatamun nabiyyin, khatamul anbiya." La, and then he explained it. La nabiyya ba'di, la inherit any gates.
Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said, there's no prophet between me and
you
the Messiah.
You have to read everything, son. You don't read one thing, you know. Take so everything.
That's a lie. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam never said that. That's a lie.
He never said he came with a new teaching. He said, I have
he didn't come with a new teaching.
He said, I've only come with what
the Holy Quran teaches. One minute.
The Prophet
Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ana khatamun nabiyyin, khatamul anbiya. And then he explained it. La nabiyya ba'di, la inherit any gates.
But Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, there's no prophet between me and
you
the Messiah.
You have to read everything, son.
Messiah.
You don't read one thing, you know.
That's a lie. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never said that. That's a lie.
He never said he came with a new teaching. He said,
He didn't come with a new teaching.
He said, I've only come with what
the Holy Quran teaches.
Our Quran is different.
Did he say that?
The Quran is the same.
No, you lie. Didn't you read that?
We pray towards the Kaaba.
No.
We pray the same five.
You don't believe.
We follow the Hajj. We follow towards the Kaaba when we pray.
He didn't do anything.
He just said Islam.
No.
Islam and Medea is a true Islam.
He said it's a fake religion.
What do you mean by true Islam? What is true Islam?
So look, if I die, are you allowed to pray janaza on me?
No.
Are you allowed to pray janaza on me?
No.
Huh?
No.
Say it, I can hear you. Are you allowed to pray janazah on me?
I can't see.
Just say it. Say no. Say you are a kafir, I'm not allowed to pray janazah on you.
I've not said that.
No. But this is your teaching. This is what Mirza Ghulam Ahmed said. This is what Nuruddin al-Hakim said. Not Nuruddin al-Hakim, Bashiruddin Mahmud said. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك Where are they?